Well, hello guys, welcome to another episode of V&A's Blissful and Brainy Kitchen. As today you might have noticed that Aarushi isn't here, but I must say that she's going to miss all the fun because today we are going to make cake pops. Guys, let's get started. For the cake pops, you'll need some cake, some Oreo, a bag for crushing the Oreos, and some milk. The Oreos are totally optional. I'm adding them because I like them. The flavor of the cake is also up to you. Also, if you're struggling on how to make a chocolate cake, you can always check the older recipes at my page. I baked the cake with my best friend Aarushi. As for this first step, we'll crush the Oreos. I'll be using a Ziploc to crush them. As you can see that I've already broken the Oreo into 2 to 3 pieces and I've peeled off the cream. A tip for you guys, that while crushing the Oreos, make sure that you have broken them into pieces. You have to secure your Ziploc very properly so that the mixture does not come out. And always use something hard to crush it. I'll be using this to crush. You can see that first it will not get it will not get crushed. You'll have to again and again open the Ziploc to let the air out and then crush again. You can see that they've already started to crush. Some part of them is left. It's done. So now I'll pour them. And as we proceed to the second step, I'll start crumbling the cake which we have baked. Tip that before crumbling the cake, you have to wash your hands very properly. Make sure that you don't do it with dirty hands, because then your germs will get into the cake. Now as you can see that I've crumbled the whole cake. Now I'll start adding the milk a little by little, because as you can see the cake has already started to bind together. And we'll also pour the Oreos. As you can see that the part where I poured the milk, it has started to bind and it has become a lot sticky than before. As I've made my mixture, now I'll start kneading them into balls. A tip for you guys, why kneading? Kneading helps us to remove the cracks which appear whenever you mold something. As you can see, I've kneaded my dough very well and now I'll be giving it a circular shape. If you guys feel that it's a bit too big, then you can always reduce the mixture. As you can see, I have here got a very nice circular shape. And now you can start making as much as you want. You can always keep this mixture in your fridge. But make sure to before using it again, you remove it and warm it a bit. As you can see, I've already made a few balls here. For the storing part, you can store the mixture in the fridge But as for the balls, you need to store them in the freezer because you need to let them settle. You can, you know, just pop them in your mouth, or to add a bit of flavor, you can pour some icing sugar. So while sieving, there's a trick how to sieve. You need to pat your sieve like this. Add just a little bit because the cake, as it is already sweet, and you can always use some horsey syrup. For the decoration part, you can always add some more things. You can add pieces of Oreos, some chocolate chips, some sprinklers, and everything else which you find might go with it. Hope you like making the cake pops with us. Please like, share, and subscribe. Bye!